Hello everybody, Sammy here, otherwise I'm a Skogmon Throw, back here again to do another video, and as you can clearly see, I am not on camera. The reason being is because I thought I might as well try doing something a little bit different from one of the videos that I try to do, or at least put together in the time that I have. And one thing that I really wanted to try and do, because I've been more active artistically for different purposes, I thought I might as well try doing one of the many videos that I often see a lot on YouTube, which is the usual art streaming video. And what I'm drawing, what you can clearly see, is I'm attempting to draw Mega City 1 from Judge Dredd. This particular piece of work that I'm doing is more of a copy and draw from their idea, and see where that goes. Because what I was originally going to do was I was going to try and draw the actual city from the comics, as opposed to how the city looked from the recent adaptation of Judge Dredd, otherwise known as Dredd. And this, I feel, just kind of turned out to be a little bit meh with the way that it looked. I mean, since I've never done one of these these art streaming videos before, and I really wanted to have a go at trying to do one of these and see how this would turn out. And I think for a first attempt at me doing one of these, I'm very indifferent towards it. I think it really turned out to be what it was. If I do one of these again, I want to try and do it a little bit better, because I thought that what I've done for this just turned out to be a little bit of a meh attempt. So with this video, I mean, there's not really much I can really talk about regarding how this video went down creatively, except for the fact that what I wanted to do was, I didn't want to do just another toy review. I wanted to really do something else, and being more active in art recently, which explains why I've been less active on YouTube, and trying to find the motivation to do a proper toy review. And when it comes to making a video, you are really in a bit of a problem, because trying to get into the motivational state to make a video is a bit of a problem, because you never really know what to say or what to talk about on camera. Especially since I love making videos, and I really do want to keep being more active on YouTube. It's hard to really just go ahead and say, oh, well, here's a toy, and I'm going to talk about it and review it and all that stuff. So I really just wanted to show you what I've been drawing, as well as just give you an idea of how this process really worked. Because if anybody who follows me, anybody who watches me on DeviantArt, anybody who's friends with me on Facebook, has seen the art that I've done recently, I'm more active in the area of drawing portrait shots of characters from various different fictions, and that's mostly been what I've been focused on. I've been mostly just focused on drawing heads and torso shots and nothing else. I mean, I'm still practicing with the different mediums of art and seeing where that would go from there. Because since getting back into it, I've been really wanting to just try and really do it a little bit more properly and improve from there. And with drawing Mega City 1 and then coloring Mega City 1, it's difficult to talk about, because I've never really attempted to draw architecture before. Architecture really isn't one of the styles of drawings that I've got much experience with. I remember drawing a inside of a cupboard when I was in secondary school, and seeing how that would look. And honestly, I think that from the way that it turned out, I thought it was just meh, because during secondary school, at that time in my life, I really wasn't happy with how I was doing art, because I was being told to draw the way that the teachers had told me, and instead of just draw it the way that you feel comfortable with drawing, which really put me off for quite a while, and really which depressed me from not really doing any art for a while. And back then I was really into art, so yeah. I mean, with drawing this, what you're seeing right now, how the process is, and if you've seen some of the work that I do, is I will draw the pencil line first, and then go over it again with ink, and then, of course, if there are any pencil marks left, I will erase those and make sure that there's nothing pencil-wise left on the paper, and then from there, color it. And with how this turned out, I mean, not much I can really say, except what I was going to do was I was going to try and make this look as detailed as possible color-wise and line work-wise, and that didn't really turn out as well as it did. So what you're left with, what you're currently seeing at the moment is basically the multiple different shades of gray and different shades of blue as an attempt to try and recreate the look of Mega City 1 from 2012's Red. And since I'm still improving, since I'm still looking into how the procedure of art is done and how that has pretty much taken me into a much larger interest, because I'm rediscovering a little bit more thanks to getting back into it. I was just really practicing with how the color I was practicing with how the colors would look. And you know, with colors, I mean, since I bought these, I recently bought these Faber-Castell pens, and I wanted to try and I wanted to use those instead of using Pearl markers because I had something on the back, which you will clearly see later on in the video. I don't think the finished result turned out that well, because some parts of it looked a little bit flat, and whereas some parts of it, which I really wanted to put more detail in, looked a little bit crappy. But honestly, I think the with how this turned out, it turned out to be okay. There's not really much more I can say about that. It just turned out to be okay. The one thing that I will say that I had a bit of a problem with was when I tried this attempt with pen before, was using a paintbrush to try and really smear the ink on the sky, which I've tried that idea before, and the result was really, really crap. So yeah, I mean, the end result for that didn't really turn out that well. So I think the one thing that I can never do properly with felt pens is to go over it with do the sky, which what I was going to do was I was trying to just smear it over with watercolor, and that didn't turn out well. So I think next time I do a background, next time I do the sky, I will use proper watercolors instead of just felted pens. One thing you might notice as well regarding this video is that the camera, because I had the camera in the most awkward angle possible, and it kept shaking when I was coloring parts of this in. So I had the camera too close during the shooting of this video, so it didn't really. I had the camera at the worst angle. I have no idea how whenever people shoot these videos, where they keep the cameras. Normally the camera is looming over the picture that they're drawing. So next time I do that, I will probably have the camera in a better position. So that's kind of a bit of a problem. And one thing as well you might notice is the if you saw it a little further back, the camera the video just edited to a different part of the coloring. There's a reason for that, because the camera that I was shooting on, it ran out of memory, so I had to remove the videos that I had these videos that I had been recording, and basically just put them away and then record the whole thing again without trying to go back and, oh shit, now that I've colored this part, I can't go back and erase what I've done because it's colored in felt pen. So yeah, it's. Yeah, I mean, I'm kind of okay with how this turned out. I mean, like I said, next time I do another let next time I do another streaming video art-wise, I want to put a little bit more effort into what I'm drawing, because I think with how this turned out, because I want to make a better video rather than just do another toy review, because like I said, I'm more active more these days in the artistic side of things as opposed to just talking about toy reviews, which, don't get me wrong, I mean, there are so many people out there that do those very well, but I really think it's a whole case of losing interest when it gets right down to it. So really, there's not much else I can say about this video except for this has been one of my first attempts at trying to draw streaming something and then recording it on video and then putting some audio to that and just seeing how that would work. So next time I do one of these, I won't probably add another commentary, because there's not really much I can say regarding those video those videos, is that how they turn out and how they develop is pretty much as they are. Final thoughts regarding this. I think this turned out okay. I think this could have been a little bit better, but like I said, next time I'll have a camera in a different angle, as opposed to having it too close where I might risk the chance of the camera falling over and having to restart the entire thing or breaking the camera and so on and so forth. So with that being said, I hope you enjoy this video, as I'm running out of time recording this, and I will catch you all soon. So take care, enjoy the rest of the video. Bye.